Hey, what's going on, YouTubers? This is Zen from Zen Multiverse, and I hope you're having a great day. So we are back with a new chapter of Dragon Ball Super number 75. And previously, we saw Vegeta just going into his new form and just kind of wailing on Granola himself. But in this chapter in particular, for number 75, we get the unveiling name of this brand new form. And it's pretty cool because as we're going through the whole entirety of the chapter itself, there's nothing but fighting, right? There is dialogue, but there's nothing but fighting going on. And Vegeta seems to be coming on top. But one of the things that Vegeta is also doing is that he's just tanking hits, right? And the more he's tanking hits, the more powerful he's becoming, right? That's proven to be as effective as it could be towards the end of the chapter, because we do see him saying, like, I'm taking too much damage, right? So he unveils the name of this new form. I'm going to just give you another picture here as he's getting truly excited and enthralled in the passion of the fight, right? Every time he's taking a hit, he's feeling just truly immersed, right? And it's making him more powerful, right? And one of the things that he does say is that he learned this power from a god of destruction. And, you know, this is in reference to Beerus himself, right? So one of the things Granola says is, did you receive this power? And then Vegeta's like, no, I didn't receive this power. This is my own power, right? So I think there still needs to be some explanation on the power itself. But through the fight that continues, Vegeta basically is telling him that we don't serve Frieza, right? Frieza's never been someone that we've been serving. And it makes Granola think about what he's truly doing. But he pushes that to the side and again comes to the conclusion that he wants to take out Vegeta for whatever reason. I still have my theories about Vegeta, Goku, and Granola teaming up eventually, because the heaters, we do see the heaters at the end gathering the Dragon Balls, and they are going to make a wish. What that wish is, we're not too sure. But Vegeta unveils the name of this new form, and he references, he said, Goku's Ultra Instinct is based on his body having a mind of on its own. And he said, no, he said, I'm all ego. He said, you know what? Let's just call this Ultra Ego, right? So the name of this form is called Ultra Ego. Am I a big fan of the name? Not so much, right? I got to be super honest in saying that Ultra Ego doesn't really catch my attention, right? But he's always been a character with pride, and the ego kind of makes sense, right? So I guess, you know, eventually as time goes on, the name is going to catch on to me. You know what I mean? Am I a fan of the form? 100%. The name, do I feel like they could have come up with another name? Yeah. Do I have a better name? I don't have a better name, right? So it is what it is. But anyway, I overall enjoyed this chapter. I'm enjoying the fight, and I'm enjoying the ability to try to predict what's going to happen, or just theorize on what's going to happen next, right? I do feel like the heaters are going to wish for something that's going to have Granola, Goku, and Vegeta teaming up with each other in order to go against whatever the heaters are going to wish for, right? They might wish to become the strongest in the universe or something too. But imagine, right? Imagine if they all wish to become the strongest in the universe, and we have a whole set of crew of heaters, right? You know, it's multiple people that they have to go against, right? So we'll see. We'll see what happens. Again, I'm enjoying this chapter, and I can't wait for the next one. Let me know your theories in the comment section. This is Zen from Zen Multiverse saying peace, love, and prosperity. If you're enjoying the content, drop me a like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and I'll catch you all later for the next one. Take care, everyone.